Hola chicos y chicas de Carreras de Montana, nos encontramos a los pies del Eiger con uno de los favoritos. Saludo a la afición española, Pau.
Hola, buenas tardes.
¿Qué tal? ¿Habías corrido alguna vez aquí?
Aquí vine el año pasado en verano, pero un viaje que hicimos de un par de semanas por los Alpes y nada, sí que entrené por la zona, pero no había corrido a carrera, así que con muchas ganas, muy ansioso de empezar y nada, a ver cómo va con este Eiger espectacular que hay aquí detrás.
Después de que arrasaste en Transgran Canaria y la plata en Lavaredo, ¿aquí las expectativas son altas?
Bueno, aquí cada uno se las pone. Yo vengo, me pongo en la salida y corro lo que puedo, lo que sé y hasta donde las piernas aguanten, ¿no? Hace 3 semanas que hice Lavaredo y bueno, he recuperado, me siento bien. Ayer salí a entrenar por aquí y me sentí bastante bien, así que nada, ahora queda solo correr, que el estómago se comporte, que las piernas estén preparadas y rápido para llegar pronto a meta.
Vale, muchas gracias. Te vemos en meta. Esperamos que como campeón. Yo intentaré seguirte.
Bueno, muy bien. Gracias a todos.
Gracias. Hello, Jiménez. Say hello to the people of Spain, to Carreras de Montana.
Hola.
How do you feel to this race?
Yeah, I'm actually good, but you know, I have some bad luck and I have inflammation, so I'm on antibiotics, so this has a side effect, so I'm not sure about my race, and like the medical staff in ITRA, they recommend me not to race because it's kind of dangerous, but I'll try to do my best and try to run at least the first part of the race and I'll see if it goes well. So I'll run the whole thing. If it's not so good, so probably I need to DNF, so yeah. But you know, life is life and it doesn't end here, so you know, I'll just go with the stream, with the flow of life, and I'll see you.
Good luck, see you tomorrow.
Ciao.
Hola otra vez chicos y chicas de Carreras de Montana. Miren, a los pies de Eiger nuevamente, uno de los integrantes del equipo de los Chacales. ¿Qué carrera corres mañana?
Mañana el I-51.
¿Y qué expectativas tienes?
Bueno, terminarlo.
Aquí mira, nos hemos encontrado con uno de los lectores de Carreras de Montana que nos sigue.
Venga, a tope chicales.
Suerte mañana.
Gracias.
Yes, that's her. you, it's very, very, very big honor for me to shake hands with the first woman 2017.
Oh wow! Well, thank you so much.
I did the Western stage a couple of years ago, but not under 24 hours. So I want to ask you: this is your first race in Europe, or Switzerland?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Blown away.
And you also know this is much more vertical than Western State.
Oh yeah.
Okay. So probably you can tell us something about your preparation. How do you train Swiss Alps in the US?
Well, I was gonna race Western States again this year, so I had a little bit of unconventional training, as in I did not train for about 6 weeks.
Okay.
And then I was a little bit sick and I wasn't sure what was wrong with me, and I found out it was my thyroid, which is easily treated with medicine. So as soon as I found that out, I bounced right back and was able to get in a very short training block. But what I did was I just, you know, it was training for Western, you want to do a lot of fast stuff and it's like so intense and, you know, and honestly, it's fun because it's fun to run fast. But when I signed up for this race, basically, I could just go play in big mountains, you know, the biggest I could find. So
okay, the steepest.
The steepest,
the most
yeah.
Steepest.
So I just did as much vert as I possibly could, you know, didn't look at time, was just having fun playing it. In Colorado, I live in Boulder, Colorado, and we're lucky to have amazing mountain access and peaks that go up to 14,000 feet. Again, don't know the metric system, what that is, but very high. and it was very steep, and it was fun. I just got to play and do something that I hadn't done in a while because all my focus for the last 2 years has been on Western.
So, welcome at this 101. Last year you were here for the E51.
Yes.
And you enjoyed it, and you're back in Grindelwald. And how do you like it, Grindelwald?
Yeah, I like it very much. And actually, last year I saw that Pau is camping here, and I decided almost for last minute to come here and to do, you know, 51. So this is probably the first time when I got in touch with Ralph, and yeah, I came to the area and like really enjoyed the views, and it was kind of my preparation, you know, to UTMB and all the stuff which went afterward, because usually I prefer to do a longer races, and if I do the shorter races, so it means it's kind of the preparation. But you know, after the last year's experience, like, I decided that I must do a longer race, yeah, and this is why I'm here. And before that, we have a trail running factory camp here, mm-hmm. so I was kind of very familiar with the area, and even though the weather and the snow, you know, we had a lot of snow here in the Grindelwald, so it didn't allow us to go on the original trails for the most of the part, but you know, I had the feeling, you know, around about the course. So my expectations were high, and I had some good, you know, moments during this camp. And I was, on some days, I was feeling like, oh, I wish it would be the day today, you know, because I feel so amazing. Yeah, but you know, life is life, and I'm kind of feeling okay, but not 100% right now because of some let's say sickness which I have. Yeah, but I'll try to do my best tomorrow. And at least I'll start, you know, I'll see how it goes, yeah, because a lot of people tells me, you know, like, listen to your body, don't start, you know, it's too dangerous, but I want to give it a try, and yeah, so I'll try to just enjoy all the course, and hopefully the weather won't be against us, and it would be not necessary to stop the race, you know, and the race will go fast, you know, and we could break the Stephens record, you know, from last year.